So let's say this is the sun, and this is the earth, and climate change is kind of like this. All that carbon dioxide we've emitted is trapping heat in the atmosphere. So now I'm gonna do a little climate modification. I'm gonna spray some aerosol particles, and that's gonna reflect some of the light from the sun. Less light coming in means less heat for the planet. This is called geoengineering. It's a broad term for all the ways to cool the climate without, you know, not burning fossil fuels in the first place. Generally, the term refers to reflecting sunlight before it gets trapped in the atmosphere. This technique works great when we're talking about light bulbs and jars, but in the real world, it gets a little more complicated. Scientists have been talking about geoengineering for about as long as they've been talking about climate change. In 1965, the president's science advisors issued their first warning about climate change. But their idea to fix it wasn't cutting back on fossil fuels. It was to put a bunch of shiny particles into the ocean. Geoengineering, circa 1965. Over the decades, scientists have come up with all sorts of similar ideas. And there's a few reasons why this is so appealing. Geoengineering is usually cheap, it would take effect instantly, and it wouldn't require that whole global cooperation to reshape society thing. To show how this works, in theory, we made this geoengineering simulator. So the world is burning a lot of fossil fuels. That's this crank here. And you can see that's making the temperature rise. And if we ever stopped burning fossil fuels, the warming would eventually stop. So what if instead of giving up fossil fuels, we started geoengineering? The carbon's still there, we're just counteracting some of that warming. But unless the world stopped burning fossil fuels, we'd have to keep up the geoengineering. Like, forever. And if we ever stopped, we'd get all of that warming back at once. Engineering a cooler world could also have some weird climate and weather impacts. See, geoengineering is not really like anti-CO2. The ways they warm and cool the world are just different. It's a little bit like this. Say you're making lemonade and you add too much lemon. And your lemonade is too sour. Geoengineering would be like adding baking soda to neutralize the acid. So your lemonade might be as sour as the recipe calls for, but also, do you really want to drink this?
So do you?
I am a little curious. Oh, that's so bad. Like really salty pancake batter. So geoengineering could stop the planet from warming overall, but things could get kind of weird at a local level, like with rainfall or cloud patterns. And we don't really know what that would look like for a city or even a country. So there are other ways to use geoengineering. Maybe you could use a little bit of geoengineering in tandem with decarbonization, and that would give us a little more time to adapt. But even these scenarios come with their risks. So geoengineering is not an ideal climate solution, at least not alone. But some scientists are saying maybe it's time to study it. Right now, most geoengineering science relies on computer models or studying volcanic cooling. There's never been a real-world geoengineering experiment. So that leaves a lot of unanswered questions about how it would work in the actual climate. Despite that, there is some interest. The 2018 IPCC report looked at geoengineering as one possible solution. And some Harvard scientists are currently scoping out a project looking at how particles behave high up in the atmosphere, kind of like our visual from earlier. Even presidential candidates are talking about it. Well, Andrew Yang is talking about it. This all sounds kind of like sci-fi, but remember, we've been unintentionally engineering the climate for more than a century. We're f***ing with the planet. The question is, can we fix it by f***ing with it some more?